In previous episodes, we looked at how to use the ProVisionaire Design software, and we focused on using the DME7 processor as our core device within our program. However, we can of course use more than one processing device within ProVisionaire Design. This might be more than one DME, for instance, but it could also include the MTX and MRX series of processors. This is what I'm going to briefly cover in this episode. Firstly, we have the MTX series. These are fixed architecture processors, which still give you a lot of flexibility and power within your installation. Starting with the MTX III, you have a range of analog and digital I/O, either in the form of Euroblock connectors, RCA connections, or Yamaha's proprietary YDIF links that allow you to create an audio bus between compatible processors and amplifiers. The MTX 5D takes the features of the MTX 3, but adds additional I/O in the form of Dante. In the past, you may have configured these devices using the MTX and MRX editor software, but if using ProVisionaire Design, the process is a little different. Firstly, we should note here that if you already have a program on your MTX system, set up using previous software, then it's not recommended to use the ProVisionaire Design software to manage that device at this time. If you're setting up a new system, however, then ProVisionaire Design may provide all the functionality that you need. So, let's start by adding one MTX 3. We can either do this from the Devices section, or if your device is already connected to the network, you can add it from the Network tab. Either way, you can drag and drop the device onto the main page. If I click once on the MTX 3 to select it, then we'll see some details in the Properties window. These include the remote control port number, for if using an external control system, a dimmer for the lights on the unit, and if I click here, I can configure the DCP control panels if I wish to use these within this design. Any that I add here will appear on this project window, and we can double click to configure them for a little later. For now, I'll leave them blank. Double clicking on the MTX 3 device will open another window where we'll see a schematic showing the layout of this device. This is how the system's configured internally. We can then click on any part of this and edit the parameters within. Every setting can be altered, and as we do this, we can save presets on the left-hand side, which we can then trigger in a number of ways. We could trigger these through our DCP panel. However, we could also trigger them through a contact closure or by using a remote control command. The control protocols are documented and available from our website. If I click on the button at the top here, labelled MTX Configuration, I can set up the I/O of the MTX 3 device. Here I can tell it what type of signal it should expect on each input type and for each output. Clicking Advanced Settings will allow us to view our matrix output routing, and will highlight the parts that you can edit. The last button at the top allows us access to four key features on the MTX 3. We can manage files on the SD card for playback. We can access the scheduler to allow us to run presets, trigger GPIs, or play files on the SD card at particular times of day. We can set up our GPI ports for use in different ways, and we can also access external events, which is where we can tell the MTX device to send commands out to another device using custom TCP or UDP commands. With the GPI ports, I mentioned here that we can tell the system what happens on each port, but if you need to calibrate the ports at all, this can be done from the system menu, and then by choosing GPI Calibration. Clicking the Online button at the top will allow us to connect to the device, so this will synchronize from device to accept its current configuration, or to device to push our newly created configuration onto the MTX. Bear in mind, as mentioned before, If the MTX has already got a program on it from the MTX editor software, the only option that will work here is to device. That's to overwrite the current configuration. ProVisionaire Design will give you an error if you try and sync from device, but it won't warn you if you try to sync to device. So it's very easy to overwrite an existing older program on an MTX device if you're not careful. Always start by syncing from device and see if the device already has a configuration loaded. If you see this error in ProVisionaire Design, then make sure to back up your current configuration through the MTX editor software if you wish to keep a copy of the existing settings. There's no way to recover a program if overwritten in this way. Adding an MTX 5D into our system, you'll see the device is similar, but much larger, and with the addition of Dante I.O. Configuration of this device is similar to the MTX 3. One section of I.O. that I haven't yet explained is YDIF, Yamaha's own proprietary audio bus. This is present on a number of our installation products, on the MTX and MRX DSPs, and our XMV amplifiers. When we have a number of compatible devices in our design, we can connect them together on the screen to establish the chain of connectivity. Then, in each processing device, we can choose which sources are routed to and from each input or output. The next part of this video relates to the MRX7D, one of our free configuration DSP processors. You may have found this video after watching the previous tutorial on ProVisionaire Design and the DME7 processor. With the MRX7D, a lot of the same actions apply. So once you've added an MRX7D into your design, and you've opened the device, you'll see a list of components in the same way that you would on the DME7. Down the side, you also have parameter sets and snapshots. These again work in the same way as on the DME7. One difference here though is that you can have snapshot groups, so you may have multiple snapshots that you can recall at once by triggering that group. This allows you even more flexibility to make complex changes with a single action, such as triggering a contact closure. By going to the menu and choosing Remote Control Setup List, we can even assign a snapshot group to a TCP trigger. This is also where we would assign any other commands that we wish to use with an external control system, by use of the API. If we think of the MRX7D as a mixer, then our parameter link groups here are like our DCAs, so they allow us to link certain aspects of a component to control them relative to each other. In this example, multiple faders that will all act together. Gang edit groups allow us to go even further with our control here. So in this menu, we can assign multiple elements of specific components and allow them to all act together. So we can bring a whole component in and just choose the parts that we wish to control. These combinations of options give us true flexibility to control and configure our system. With the MRX7D, we use the compile function, which works in the same way as on the DME7. Then, once we're ready, we can save our project, and then we can bring the project online on the device, which synchronizes the configuration. Your system's now live and it's ready to go. The final thing that I'll talk about in this video is the ADECIA components, or the RM series. For those unfamiliar with the ADECIA system, it's a combination of components that allow simple conferencing and other audio capabilities, using very advanced microphones and speakers. By itself, the ADECIA system can use an auto-setup procedure and can detect components to then route audio for conferencing purposes. However, if you want advanced voice lift capabilities, then you may find yourself combining the RM series microphones with another processor such as the MRX7D or DME7. The RM series microphones are all Dante connected. They have built-in AEC capabilities for conferencing and some advanced processing. However, they also have a second output that runs at lower latency and is designed for voice lift. This channel can be passed into another processor to give the best flexibility. Within ProVisionaire Design, you can bring in your RM series microphones, along with entering any security passcodes for your devices. You can then bring them online and make live changes to the microphone settings to adapt them to the room. You can design a voice lift system for your MRX 7D or DME 7 device, and you can then jump into Dante Controller and route the secondary Dante channel on the microphone to whichever processing device that you're using. Hopefully this video is useful to get you started with these additional Yamaha devices within ProVisionaire Design. Check out the other videos in this series to see more details about the software.